Well, it was the only class that didn't manage to get the medal race away in Aarhus because of the weather for the World Championships, which was a big shame because it was so close. And it's the top boats challenging here in Enoshima as well, with the Italians and the Australians. The top four positions held by those two countries. Top five, potentially, could still all win gold. Top six are in with a chance at silver or bronze, but really not much in it, and the Italians are the ones to catch.
Now it's going to be a big fight. We have a lead, which is a few points, so we're going to fight in the medal race.
They came out on top and claimed the World Championship title in Aarhus, and they are really firing at the moment.
They're on a roll. I mean, they've pretty much won everything in 2018, the Worlds including, and they're definitely the one to beat in this medal race. But it's really close in points, really exciting, and really looking forward on getting this race underway.
Yeah, we can see Ruggero Tita and Caterina Banti of Italy there preparing for the start of their race. And right behind them, trying to close the gap from Australia, Jason Waterhouse and Lisa Darmanin.
Always going for gold. That's a silly question. Of course we're going for gold. No, second sucks. We want to win.
Of course it does. They're on 32 points. The Italians are on 27. It's going to be tough.
Yeah, it's going to be tough, but you know, they were second in Rio. They were already, you know, disappointed with that. So I think, yeah, they're really coming for the gold, and they will do everything they can to beat Tita and Banti. They're only five places behind, so definitely all to play for. Especially in these tricky conditions, as we've seen in the first two races.
So two Italian boats, two Australians, eight nations in total represented in this Nacra 17 race. There had been a complaint by the Australians, by Nathan Outeridge and his sister Hayley Outeridge. They protested the Italians for what they claimed were illegal foils on the Nacra. The protest has been dismissed, so we are racing as we were.
It's a really interesting point that kind of keeps being flagged up now because of the Nacra 17 going into the foiling mode. Everything about the foils is coming down. That's so important. And because of that, sailors are looking for every single edge possible. And of course, there are the measurement and the guidelines that they've got to stick within. But again, it is that hunger to win. It's that pushing, that constant development. Where can they make these gains? And the foils are one area that obviously are going to be key for anyone. But again, looking at sort of the Outeridge brother and sister, Nathan and Hayley sort of stepping in, they've not long been in the boat together and already starting to contend for some medal places. So again, it'll be interesting, even though, again, we're 2 years out, from or just under 2 years out, and they'll be pushing hard for their spot in the Nacra. But again, with Waterhouse and Darmin up in front of them, they're going to have some fierce battles for that team selection.
Now, is it just me, or is that water looking a little bit more choppy than it was earlier on today?
I think it's got a little bit more sort of movement to it. That's due to, again, just this breeze. But it's with this offshore breeze, it is remaining reasonably flat. Certainly radically different to what the sailors had a week or so ago on the back end of that typhoon. We saw a lot of images being posted up on Facebook and social media of boats flying out of the water and all sorts of breeze. And so it does show that every single day, and it highlights something that we talked about earlier in the show about having the time on the water, putting that time into the boats and understanding all the conditions they could get. They could have a day like this, or they could have a day with some strong breeze and some big waves, and you're going to be able to sail in all of those conditions.
3 minutes to go. Let's have a look at the course that they're going to be racing.
So we'll start with an upwind towards the first mark. We'll have an offset and then go downwind towards the gate. And then we'll do the same thing again. So we'll do a windward leeward, not with a reaching this time, but just with the finish line being the same as the starting line. Windward leeward, 2 laps.
2 minutes 30 to go, and we're looking at the start line between that white committee boat at the top of this shot and this inflatable at the bottom, and how they lined it up.
So at the moment there is still that slight advantage down towards the committee boat end, but it is moving around, this wind again constantly moving around, which neutralizes that start line. We've seen it happen in the final sort of 20-30 seconds of the last two starts, the RSX men and women starts. So will that happen again? Will we see the boats protecting the mid to left-hand side? Again, with the Nacra 17, it is a fairly maneuverable boat now, but it still doesn't like going round corners. If it can be given a straight line to accelerate, they will do. So a lot of these teams will be putting in their positions where they want to be going, and I'll be surprised if many want to head out towards that right-hand side. So if a lot of them have been watching last few races, we'll see a bulk of them protecting. And an area where a lot of the sailors will be keen to stay in is just to the leeward of that pack. Some might approach from that port hand side, put themselves to the leeward part of that pack, and it allows them a little bit of control, allows them to sail a slightly lower mode and go into speed, or be able to sail a slightly higher mode and close some of the gaps. So it's going to be a really interesting one. But with the points so tight, it is about people going out and racing their own race.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. It's almost no bias anymore at the starting line. So the wind has shifted a little bit towards the left. And I think, yeah, the majority will head towards that left side just because it's a little bit safer.
You see them all hanging back a little bit further to enable that acceleration. But look, already we can start to see the battle between the two Australian boats. Again, very happy to use this as good training, but again, trying to get themselves on that pecking order. With 30 seconds to go, you can see them both approaching on that port hand side, which I talked about, allows them to see the fleet tacking in underneath that leeward part of it and gives them nice control at the start.
So we've got the two Australians at this end of the shot, and now both Italian boats are moving down the back of the fleet there towards this end of the line as well. We'll see how it pans out as the clock counts down for this Nacra 17 medal race here in Enoshima. The clock is zero. The race has begun. And everyone is over the line, with the Australians closest to us, the Italians just staying in touch, staying close, and they all seem to have come out this way.
It was a delayed sort of response on that, whether people pulled the trigger early enough. But again, we started to see a little bit of a sag in the middle part of the line, which is where boats in that midsection find it hard to judge exactly where that line is. And so they're reliant on the boats at either end, which gives you a strong position. If you start at a committee boat end or the pin end, you've got a fixed point to be able to position off. That's exactly where these boats have come off. And so straight in front of us, Waterhouse and Diamond, sort of down off this pin end again, looking for that speed and accelerating away. And you can see them sailing a slightly lower angle just to escape out towards this left-hand side. But a lot of the boats all staying in this starboard mode, but looking very comfortable up in that midsection are your lead boats over towards that right-hand side.
Yeah, so great start by Waterhouse and Darmanin. But it looked like just at the moment of the start, the wind shifted 10, 12 degrees towards the right, which explains why the top pack is a little bit in favor with Gulari and Scott actually in a great position, but I think it's about to shift back towards the left, and we should see Darmanin and Waterhouse taking that advantage of going a little bit lower and going for more speed.
Well, that's a great shot there. Looking back across that fleet, going into that lower bit, they were right down into that low and slow mode. And now, both up on that, you see the adjustments of the trapezes, pulling it in and dropping down. And look at the acceleration away. So it shows how quick these boats are up onto the foils and accelerating away, and the speed difference. So getting out towards this left-hand side. And so, yeah, full advantage to this team out. Furthest boat towards the left as we pan back and look across towards the right. They'll be looking to get back towards that mid part of the fleet to defend their position fairly shortly.
So although first and second going into this race have gone onto this left-hand side, the other Italian boats of Bissero and Frascari, who started in third, have gone, they went out to the right-hand side, and they've now tacked back in, heading towards us now. So they definitely chose a different route, but it's Waterhouse and Darmanin out in front at the moment. Scolari and Scutt of the USA, and then our overall leaders, Tita and Banti, in third.
You can see how drastically the breeze is changing across this race course. Look, they're both in. One sat on the tram, sat right down onto this windward hull. And then we've seen them both go out onto that trapeze.
Yeah, and we see that Tita and Banti, the boat that is furthest on the screen, just tack. And yeah, it doesn't surprise me that Waterhouse and Darmanin also going for the tack. They are a little bit under or close to the left ley line, so great position for them to be in. But they didn't take the initiative, so I hope that the breeze stays on this side. But some strange things would happen if it wouldn't be like that compared to the other races.
Yeah, coming back in towards that mid part of the course, giving themselves that control. Wind just giving a little bit of a shift towards that right-hand side, so giving that favour up that middle part of that race course. But we have seen in this top third of the race course that breeze coming good on this left-hand side. And it has generally favoured boats that have even travelled over that ley line and getting out towards that left side. So a lot of the key leaders are all positioning themselves well on this port hand shift, coming back across, minimizing the amount of maneuvers they've got as they come back across. But certainly the breeze looks light across the whole course at the moment, but will we see it start to filter in and fill in on this left hand side?
So not a great start for Bissero and Frascari of Italy, who started the day in third. They took the wrong decisions on that start. They're currently sitting in 10th, right at the back. And that has helped Nathan Outridge and Hayley Outridge move up into a bronze medal position as things stand. But early days yet as we reach the midway point of this very first leg of the Nacra 17 medal race.
Yeah, the wind just starting to stick on this right side a little bit more, enabling these boats to climb up, which is what's changing that leaderboard radically around. But look, it looks very soft over on that far right side again, and seeing boats drop in. Even though this boat, as we're looking straight at, is the Australian pair coming in on that left-hand side. They are the furthest boat towards that left-hand side. Still looks light with them to the positions they're in. So it's definitely the breeze going soft, about 7 knots across this race course, but it is flicking towards that right-hand side as they tack straight in front of their rivals, the Italian pair, and lead them back in towards the centre of the course to give them the opportunity to head left or right. But again, this is where we started to see in the RSX races protecting this mid to left side. But look at the big shift there. The bows have gone down and how light that breeze has gone. Got 6.5 knots of breeze at the moment. And certainly looking at their positions in the boat, I would have said that looks even less on the water to where they are now.
Yeah, I think they're looking for some more pressure going towards that left. Like most of them, like all of them are back on starboard tack again, finding the extra pressure on the left ley line if there is any left, or if there's fresh pressure, it'll come from that side. And we can see here that the Australian boat, like Waterhouse and Darmanin, are greatly covering Tita and Banti, who's going into the tech to get clear air and will, well, finally mirrored again by the Australians.
Really interesting watching the two different tacking techniques there, sort of watching Tita and Banti really swing down towards that back right corner, dig that corner in and spin it round very, very quickly so that it comes out and allows them to build that pace quicker. But it was a slow attack. And then watching the Australian pair go into a much slower sort of old school tack, but enables them to continue a bit of momentum out.
For the Italians, though, they can sit there all day. They are in the dominant gold medal position. As things stand, there's still 3 points between them and the Australians overall. So as long as things stay as they are, the Italians still have it. So for them, it's just a case of staying calm, playing the game, and just staying up there in the front and making sure they don't get anything wrong.
Yeah, that's it. They don't necessarily need to win this race or need to be in front of Waterhouse and Darman to claim the gold, but they cannot really lose a lot either, so they really need to keep their eyes open during this race. The breeze is dying a little bit, so it will become more tricky, and if you have a little bit of extra pressure, especially in the Nacra, speed differences can be huge, so still a lot to play for.
And there we get a good view as they approach the top mark, get a good idea of the distance and the ley lines that they're heading for.
Yeah, and you can see that the Outridge, Nathan and Haley, they made huge gains going towards the left on top of the other ones. Just a little bit of extra pressure and...
Great move
therefore
from
now
the Outridges.
Yeah, definitely in first position rounding that top mark.
So perfectly timed, perfectly positioned. Some great strategy from Nathan Outridge at the helm, getting ahead of their teammates and rounding that top mark in the lead. It's an Australian 1-2. Then come the overall leaders, Tita and Banti of Italy. And I think right behind the Italians are their teammates. I need to just get a good shot of that, but it'll be remarkable if they have worked their way back up the fleet. Yes, they have. Bisseran Frascari of Italy, who had a pretty poor start, were 10th on that second half of the first leg, have moved up into fourth place. So a good performance, a remarkable comeback from the second Italian boat, as we are with the leaders from Australia.
There's definitely a little bit more breeze now. It was down to 5-6 knots, but at the moment we're looking at 8-9 knots. They're nicely foiling downwind. And we're here on board with, I think, Waterhouse and Darmanin, who just went into a jibe. And I think the rest will follow closely. They're on the ley line going downwind, and all of them are pretty much going on that left side looking upwind, just as it was, you know, that's where the gains came from in that upwind, especially towards the top of the mark where Outridge gained so much in that last part.
So the leaders are on a bit of a procession towards the bottom mark now, and the four top boats going into the race are also the four top boats here, but they have shuffled the pack, so we have a different order with the Outridges in front in this medal race, third overall, their teammates in second, and the Italians sitting third. Again, the Italians in a good strong position to hold on to that gold medal. Still holding on to a 3-point advantage over Waterhouse and Darman. Yeah, remarkable comeback from Bisseran and Frascari, who were right at the back of the fleet, about halfway up the first leg, and managed to turn their fortunes around and are now back in the hunt.
And they're coming full speed, really, really closing that gap.
So our four leading boats coming in towards that bottom gate.
Ooh.
Here come the Australians.
Hit by a gust.
Waterhouse and Darman in reach the gate in the lead. Then comes Tita and Banti. The Outridges are third. I think actually it was Bisseran Frascari who I keep talking about their comeback. They've now worked their way up into second place.
Yeah, they had a super pressure.
So what did we see there? A sort of a puff of pressure. Yeah,
a puff
of
pressure.
That.
You could see it as like a darker colored area on the water, which I could see it on the analytics. They were traveling at 17 knots of speed, while the rest was at 5, 6, and then it goes so quickly if you're into some pressure. We can actually see it here. The wind has definitely increased compared to 5 minutes ago.
And look what that change in pressure and change in race order has done to the change in medal colours. Tita and Banti are now fighting for gold and silver because Bissero and Frascari moving up, ironically, has made Tita and Banti's life a little bit more difficult. But Tita and Banti now regaining control on this upwind leg.
Yeah, so Bissero and Frascari definitely going a little bit on the other side, like choosing a different pathway. They have to do something. So they were a little bit behind, so they're taking a little bit more risk than the others, just trying to find the advantage on the right side, but still going towards the left, but just towards the right. And it'll be interesting to see how that works out.
So everything very much to race for amongst the leading four boats in this Nacra 17 medal race. There we're looking at the overall leaders, Tita and Banti of Italy. Tita, the helmsman, 14th in Rio in the 49. He switched to the Nacra after those games. And the whole team really has made huge progress after having taken time out last winter to go training in Cagliari, and they're seriously considering doing the same this winter, going down there in January and February. And what they learned here this week is that you can get some pretty big wind, pretty big waves in Enoshima, and they're going to concentrate on some big wave training down in Sicily as well over the winter. But right now the focus is on this race. Two Italian boats challenging the lead. But the one we're looking at is Tita and Banti, the overall leaders. And the Australians, the brother and sister, the Outrages, currently sitting in third. You can see just how close it is there. The four leading boats laid out nicely in front of us. And again, Tita and Banti skipping down into a silver medal position because their teammates have moved up in this race.
Yeah, so we see the two Australian teams and Tita and Banti far out on the left, quite close to the ley line, or maybe even a little bit over, and Bissari and Frascari choosing a little bit of a different route. And we're going to see a crossing, I think, within the next 10 seconds. Or 15 seconds, at least.
hard to see
from the desk here. But I'm pretty sure, yeah, that they will see each other soon.
Yeah, just looking at that breeze coming in from that left-hand side again. Starting to strengthen on that mid-left, a little bit of a lift coming in. It's really interesting. Same thing, we saw the Outrages make that gain. Here we go, coming in from that left-hand side. A perfect example of this as they come in from that left side. So a big gain made from that mid-left-hand side again. So we're seeing as soon as you commit yourself towards that right side a little bit, you're really starting to struggle in that top section. As soon as you're in this top third of the race course, you've got to be approaching from this mid-left side. We see a little bit of a lift every single time before they bear away and then set up for their rounding.
So, here are the leaders approaching the top mark. It's Waterhouse and Darmamit of Australia out in front, followed by their teammates in second. Around the spreader they go. Here come the Italians. Our overall leaders, though, sitting back in fourth, just coming into the shot there. And that position will see them slip to silver.
That's it. The pressure's really on this downwind there. You can see they're trying to get up onto the foils. Now it starts to fly. Look how far forward the crew is moving, a huge amount. You watch their body weight move backs and forwards to try and just keep the balance on those foils. A big push with the legs. Huge amount of power needs to go through those legs. Not just holding onto the trapeze, but just getting that foil position right. So look at the jibe coming in early behind them from the Ausridges. Will we see that prompt something from this lead pair out in front? They're looking back over their shoulder, keeping an eye on it, but are very content. Nice speed down this left-hand side. Look comfortably in control of this race course, and certainly looking at the breeze that we've got, the breeze looks more stable and consistent on this side of the course again.
So it's the two cousins from Australia in first, the brother and sister from Australia in second. Then it's Bissa and Frascari of Italy in third. And Tita and Banti, if they want to regain that gold medal, need to move up a position.
Yeah, definitely. So Waterhouse and Darmanin really need to hold on to that first position to hold on to or to win the gold in this race. So they will try everything to do to keep Nathan and Haley Outridge behind them, although they've chosen a different pathway. And one of them is going right and one of them is going left. So it's the first time that we see this huge split actually on the downwind, and somebody is choosing to go on the left. Yeah.
Perfect. A great example. Now we've got all four of them locked in, and you can see the gaps creeping out. And exactly as you said, sort of the Outridges being able to commit over towards the other side of the race course. But again, looking at the angles, they're actually coming down to that. They are doing the long jibe. They are the ones committing down to that side. But we've always seen that breeze start to soften in that corner. Will they struggle with that breeze softening again? And will we see Bissari and Fresciari come in on that right and make a gain against the Outridges?
They're running out of racetrack, the Italians, if they want to move up to take the gold. Waterhouse and Darmanin approaching the finish line. As you can see, there are our leading boats. Got a cross there. Being the Italians. And our leaders flying downwind towards the finish line.
So again, committing down on that left side, but now coming back through towards the finish.
Going to need... And Waterhouse and Darmanin cross in first place in this medal race. And is it enough? It looks like it might be for a gold medal. Coming in second place behind them, Bissa and Frascari of Italy right now.
Very
and the Australians,
tight.
What are they doing on the finish line? The Outridges? Well,
very tight on that line, and from what looking at that, it literally looked like they had lost their position to the Italians there, which will have of course changed the medal position as they came across that line. And so it just looked like sort of it was more of a from the Outridges, it looked more like there was just a frustration as they came across that line and were just stuffing the boat up rather than anything technical.
So Waterhouse and Darmanin did everything they had to. They needed to get two boats between themselves and the Italians, Tita and Banti, and they did that. They won in some style in the medal race. Bissa and Frascari took the bronze by finishing in second. The Outrages finished third, and Tita and Banti have slipped from gold to silver with a fourth place finish in the medal race. So those were the overnight leaders. They looked in an excellent position for holding that gold, but in the end they saw it slip away with a fourth place finish in the medal race, and the gold goes to Jason Waterhouse and Lisa Darmanin of Australia. And it would be interesting to get the Italians' reaction there. Do you think that was a medal lost, or was it a medal won by the Australians?
It was a bit of a... Well, you could look at it in both ways from each side. Sort of, it was a fantastic race coming off from the start, and we'll delve into the analytics and break that down anyway. But it's interesting that the Italians off that start line, they stuck in that sort of midsection of the line and basically put themselves under pressure off that start line. So really tough, but... Okay, well, let's have a look into that and crack down exactly what came from that question. So let's go to that all-important start line. And so you can see there's already a little bit of a sag in that midsection of that race. So you can see boats hanging back, and that's just because they're a little bit unsure of where that line is and identifying exactly when to pull that trigger. It's easier with the fixed points to that pin end. And again, we see a great start from Waterhouse and Darmin as they come off this left side. You can see the breeze looking quite light as they come away, just starting to get up onto the trapeze and load up that bit of power. But already they're able to sail their own line and where they wanted to. Again, the bulk of the fleet sitting in that midsection of that line, trying to come off, everyone holding on this starboard lane. But now let's jump through to scene two, and this shows the difference between the breeze. So now look at the crew here. This is Tita and Bandy right tucked into the middle part of the boat, starting to ounce out every bit of speed. But shortly you'll see them go out onto the wire. There we are, out onto the wire. But the difference in speed now, jumping down to this far left-hand corner, this is where we've seen that breeze stay consistent. The Australian pair here down in this bottom left, high up on that on their wire, very clean on the trapeze, making that alteration here on board with them now. So you can see a lot of pressure difference across that race course. And that's how things shook up as we got up towards that top mark. So let's jump up to scene three and that windward mark. And this was a gain made from Outridge, Nathan Outridge and Haley Outridge coming in from that port left-hand side. They approached from that side, protecting that midsection. They got a nice little lift, and it gave them that opportunity to be able to tack and get that jump out in front. But we see that breeze being tricky across that race course for the rest of that race, and downwind it certainly shook things up. So you can see how tight they were in and trying to get round that mark. The breeze a lot lighter at this top part of the course. So now let's jump down towards that gate. And so you can see how things panned out. Even though Outridge, the duo, were leading, they circled down towards that right-hand side. You can see them approaching from that side, but very more powerful, more breeze coming in from Waterhouse and Darminen as they go over. Take this inside line. They lead round here, and suddenly again, the Italian pairing, they come in. We have Tita and Banti just tucking in behind them. Mascari and Fascari heading out towards the other side. So a nice split at the gate, showing that it wasn't clear cut of where they wanted to be at the gate. Tita and Banti struggling with a bit of performance on the gate. So there we see in the bottom right hand corner, not a great rounding for them. And this is how things panned out going upwind. A lot of places stayed fairly static, and we see the big gains coming in from this top to middle left hand side of the race course. So again, it's something that all the sailors need to be and keep an eye on and protect, this middle left side coming in from this approach. And that's where we saw the gain for Waterhounds again. They jumped out up in front, and it was a matter of just holding that consistency out all the way forward. So onto the downwind leg, and looking at the graphic to identify where all of they are, the two Australian boats out in front. But that's not, of course, how it panned out. So far, Jason Waterhouse, Lisa Diamond, as they head in towards that finish line, they had a nice run down there on that lower line. Bassari and Frascari, they are the ones that applied their pressure to Outridge and Outridge. Tita and Banti just had to watch things unfold as we came down towards the finish. And so the final scene is, of course, that lead boat. They take in the jump, taking the gold medal here, high up on the foils, crossing back. But again, it wasn't as clear cut as that. Straight away, see Jason Waterhouse look out the back to identify where the other boats were. And that's where we see the Outridge pair come across that finish line, just lose out to Bisari and Fiscari at that section there on the finish. And that was the medal that they just slipped away from them on those final few meters. So very tricky conditions out on the course, but certainly the sailors have got to start protecting that mid to left-hand side.
It's interesting with this class of boat, isn't it? Because we've seen new partnerships formed to compete in the foiling Nacra. We've seen sailors move from other classes into the Nacra 17. And you get a sense that they're still not 100% sure what they're getting in all the differing conditions from the boat.
No, well, we can see how radically it changes from what they're used to and being in that displacement mode and working around that to suddenly that little sniff of breeze. And this is where it's most tricky, and it's the same we saw for the boards as well, is they're in planing mode or they're in pumping mode, and it's dropping in and out of that section of when do you commit into getting onto the foil. So you can spend a lot of energy trying to get the boat onto the foil. Certainly with the Nacra, it's sailing slightly lower, getting that bit of speed on, allowing the boat to come up onto the foils. Or do you keep it in a higher mode, in displacement mode, to allow you to close a bit more distance on that mark? And it's finding that balance, and that's where all the sailors are still trying to do that. They're still trying to adjust how to get onto the foils quicker than anybody else, and because the speed difference is radical. So a lot of tuning, a lot of technique still coming in from all of the sailors. But certainly when the race course is that tricky with the wind shifting, and certainly in strength as well, it's going to be a real lottery of a race course for all of them for quite some time.
Let's confirm the overall results for you in the Nacra 17. Gold then. Waterhouse and Darmanin with a terrific final performance and victory in that medal race. Tita and Banti making do with silver. And Bisseron Frascari, who started in the bronze medal position, did enough to hold on to that bronze, and the Outridges, who finished the medal race in third, finish in fourth overall. And John Gimson, Anna Burnett of Great Britain started the day in fifth, finished the day in fifth.